I seem to be part of some television documentary. I'm one of the many making my way up the hill with the river still in sight. I see Brad and a girl who must be his sister because they look exactly alike. I comment on his old look. What are you doing here, I ask. He acts detached, introduces me to his sister. I notice he's with a girl. Is that your new girlfriend, I ask. He says she's someone he met in Cincinnati on the way up. I'm furious. He was coming to see me, but then he brought someone. I take him into a room that exists off the road and I proceed to beat the shit out of him. I'm hysterical. I hit and hit and hit and hit and hit him, mostly in the face. He takes it all devoid of expression. That just makes me madder. Finally, I stop, humiliated that I put on such a display. He goes back out to the road, and I decide, two can play that game, and look for a telephone. Hazel is there. She tells me I only have 24 hours, so I feverishly try to locate the other Brad that I used to go out with, calling his mother, then his house. No response. Deciding I don't have enough time, I don't call his work. Fuck it, I think. I'll just spend the time with family. I'm walking along the unfamiliar streets in town, and I meet Nicholas on the street. He looks healthy and happy. Nicholas, hi, I say. He's very friendly, and we have a conversation. Then it dawns on me. Oh my God, I said. I thought you were dead. That's what everyone thinks, he says. He proceeds to explain to me that he got tired of being sick, so he just got up and left. I'm confused. I don't understand. What about the funeral? What about the body they buried? He doesn't clarify. He just asks me if I'm going to the new club. Yeah, I guess so. See you there, he says. I make my way to this club. Everybody's waiting in line. Someone's passing out orange Navajo blankets. I take one and wrap it around me. Just like the hostages when they arrived in Weissbaden. I see Brad pass by with his sister and that girl. He sees me but ignores me. I guess I follow him because the next thing I know I'm going to feel in the woods with him and Kenny and the group. They're on a picnic. The clearing is covered with sand and I get to the others who are picnicking on the blankets. Brad and I make our way through a thicket of garbled roots that belong to an ancient oak tree. We're really having quite a time negotiating through the tree and through the roots. There just never seems to be enough room in the openings. It's quite a struggle. We both become exhausted trying to find our way through this maze of roots. It seems to bring us together. Are we friends again? It seems that way when I finally break through. Free from the roots, I start to dance in the sand. Dance in the sand. Dance in the sand. Say is that I don't want to run too fast. I can see glass in the sand.